Hey, Mark Shepard, your singing hypnotist, your mind mastery mentor, and I'm here on day 4 of my transformational 90-day challenge, my fourth one. I don't know which one it is for you. I hope you will explore the idea of the 90-day challenge with me in the days to come and do what you can do. Do what you can do. Go where you need to go. Come and check back every day. I will be making some kind of video that will either be conversational hypnosis or some kind of mind mastery message that can hopefully lock in to where you're going on your journey so as to be supportive, right? Today, I hadn't had a chance to read this book I've been reading for the last couple of days because my friend Michael Guerin was here and I was all fired up in a new hypnosis song came in 2 days ago yesterday, and so this morning I had some time to read this book, Grit, by Angela Duckworth, and this is really where it's at, and I'm reading the chapter about parenting, and ultimately, one of the challenges I have had in the last 15 or 20 years as someone, an energy healer, a hypnotherapist, an NLP practitioner, is helping people to clear the childhood, what we call limiting decisions. In childhood, we decide the world is a certain way and that we need to be a certain way in order to get through this world. And 9 times out of 10, 99 out of 100, 999 times out of 1,000, we have been handed this childhood template by our parents. There's an often quoted quote from James Baldwin, the author and activist, and basically he said, you know, children don't always listen to their parents, but they will always imitate them. And one of the key pieces that Angela Duckworth really gets to throughout the book is that there are people with talent, and they often never experience failure. An example of that is Billy Beane, the general manager of the Oakland A's. The book Moneyball by Michael Lewis was written about him. And as a player, before he got into the management of baseball, as a player, he had all the tools in high school. I mean, he was the perfect player. He looked good. He had all the talent he needed. However, he had never learned to fail. And when he got to the major leagues, he just couldn't get beyond his failures. He had no strategy for picking himself up, dusting himself off, and getting back in it. And over the last 40 years as a singer-songwriter who had the talent but not the grit to actually do what was necessary to get his music out, I kept failing and I kept falling down. And I would give up for long periods of time, but it was this inner push, these songs that would come through, and this desire to constantly improve myself that turned me to self-help, turned me to books. How can I find ways to get to where I want to go when I am just not hardwired to deal with all these setbacks and failures and people saying, nah, your music's not that good, or yeah, I don't like your music. I had a girlfriend once who, after the first date, basically told me that she didn't like my music. And yet I still dated her, right? Like, why would I do that? And so for me, there's an emerging awareness that talent is great, but there's a lot of talent in the world. It comes to the notion of grit, the notion of, sure, you have talent, but are you willing to work hard, right? And the question is, perhaps as young people, who are our mentors? Who are our coaches? I didn't have any. I knew no one who was a singer-songwriter who could take me under their wing and guide me. There was no one. My parents didn't know what to do with me. And I think both my parents were well-meaning. My mom often preached, Mark, you don't want to be a musician. She would often tell me to give up, right? That's not a good message, right? Her whole phrase was, if at first you don't succeed, give up, ha, ha, ha. But as a little kid, we don't understand, parents don't understand that children are totally literal. And we have to be careful what we tell our kids. Well, as grown-ups, we are our own parents. So we have to be careful what we tell ourselves, right? And there's a fine line between being demanding of yourself and being a bully. We don't want to bully ourselves. We want to hold ourselves to a higher standard and demand that we give consistent effort, consistent work towards what we want. So Angela Duckworth kind of came up with this kind of a grid for parenting. And I'm just going to open the book here to make sure I don't mess this up and make sure I do this right. So she talks about permissive parents, and on the other side, authoritarian and neglect. Neglectful parenting. And over here, the sweet spot, wise parenting. And I think this would be something that I think would be really helpful. And this thing is supportive. And this is unsupportive. Hopefully you can read my handwriting. Right? All right, so it's very early in the morning as I'm doing this, by the way. So we have the permissive parent. You see these parents, and the kids are all crazy, and they have no discipline whatsoever. And then you see the authoritarian parent, where the children are like meek little, you know, submissive slaves. You know, and they just go, "Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am." Yeah. Right. And then we have wise parenting, where there's permission and support to be who you want to be, and then there's the demand that you work hard. That's all. That's all it is. It's like the parent saying, "No, you can't quit." She uses the example of the Hall of Fame quarterback Steve Young, who freshman year in college at Brigham Young University, he was a Mormon kid, and that's where you go when you're a Mormon, I guess. And he wanted to quit. He was like the eighth string quarterback, and he was literally just. He felt like it wasn't going to work out. And his dad was like, "No, you can't come home. You have to finish this. Keep working. Do your best," right? And it seems on the surface like Steve Young's parents were tyrannical, right? But the reality was they were loving and supportive, yet demanding, right? She uses another example of a woman who is a really well-known comedian, whose name is escaping me. I should do my due diligence and find out and report her name. Francesca Martinez, and I'm going to look her up on YouTube. She's a comedian in the UK, and she had cerebral palsy as a kid, and her parents were very permissive, let her drop out of high school to pursue her comedy stuff, but yet also demanding as well, right? Demanding, supportive, encouraging, not allowing kids to give up on themselves. And to me, that fits right in with my bullying prevention programs, because what I see is people focusing anti-bullying, trying to get everybody to be nice, trying to get the bullies to be nice. But what happens is the bullies learn to look like they're being nice, right? And no one is giving the targets of the bullying support for managing their own internal state and dealing with adversity. Because ultimately, how we deal with adversity, we all have adversity. The squirrel outside my window that I always look at and go, "Oh yeah, there's a squirrel." They have to deal with adversity too. There are hawks. They have to find their food every day, right? They're dealing with other squirrels who want to push them out of their dominant position, right? There is adversity in everything in life. Life is not always easy. And if you look at any organisms, the ones that grow against adversity are stronger, right? Nietzsche said, "What does not kill me makes me stronger." And the thing is that as a parent, and I'm, again, when I talk about parenting, I'm talking about you parenting yourself, me parenting myself. And I was a quitter. I would hit some resistance and I would back away from it. As a kid, highly sensitive kid, easily traumatized. You may be like this. Most of my clients seem to be highly sensitive people who life seems to rattle and shakes them up. And we have to learn how to stick with it, how to stick with ourselves, how to have support. And that's my intention of my Honest Hypnosis website, as well as my music, as well as all the different things that I do, is to send out my ideas in a way that mentor and support you, and hopefully in a loving way, a supportive way, and a demanding way. I demand that you stop giving up on yourself. I demand that you actually, if you spent your TV time, if you stopped watching TV and watched my videos every day instead, your life would change. And I know that for a fact. That's why I keep putting this out. And I'm ahead of the curve because right now I have a small audience. And that's fine because you know what? I keep coming back to this place where when I am authentic and true to my vision and to myself and open my heart to you and express the fact that I'm right here with you working on this stuff, that to me says, hey, you're not alone and I'm not alone. I may be a little farther along on the path. I may be your Adirondack guide. I know the trail, right? I'm here to help you if you need it, but you have to walk the walk, right? We are working on walking our talk, and we are working on changing the kind of internal self-talk that we have, because we have often internalized a critical parent, a neglectful parent, an abusive parent, a bullying parent, because our parents didn't know crap a lot of times about how to raise us. And that's as it should be, because we are put here. This is kind of a challenge. We've been given a little book. It's kind of like a video game, if you think about it. This particular avatar, this particular character has these strengths, these weaknesses, right? And has to confront challenges. Ooh, well, that's life. It's the game. I call it the game. But it's more like deep game, right? It's not dating game. It's deep game, the game of life, the strategic process of you step by step becoming who you really want to be. And sometimes we have to start as nobody. As I said in my most recent hypnosis song that I'm still working on today, it's running through my head right now. I woke up with it in my head this morning. And for me, the integration of my music and my message and the methods with which I have steadily and profoundly transformed my life, I want to share that with you. I want people to understand you can change, you can grow. And I'm looking for people who are willing to work on themselves. I'm looking for people who read books or listen to books, who are constantly improving, who have the understanding that our minds are changeable. Our brains are plastic. We have the ability to add new neurological connections to the very last breath that we have here on this planet. So today, I just want to encourage you. I want to let you know that I believe in you. And ultimately, where else are you going to get this? If you can find what I'm offering someplace else, go and get it, right? I want to love you. This is what this site is about. I'm in the process of shifting my focus from this idea I had a year and a half ago that, okay, I need to be the honest hypnotist. I need to tell people, you know what? I don't wave a magic wand. I help you to run your mind so that you can wave the magic wand. And unfortunately, very few people want to hear that. And that's okay. I don't need to work with everybody. I only want to work with people who understand that hypnosis is really the process of you learning how to drive the rocket ship, the spaceship of your body and your life so that you can get more and more of what you want and less of what you don't want. And that is a process. There's not a little finite switch that you just switch after your first hypnosis session and suddenly your life is perfect. You know, you don't come to a hypnosis session to lose weight and then go home and do nothing different and lose weight. It doesn't work like that. The hypnosis is to get you to go home and start doing something different, right? To start moving your body intelligently, to start eating the kinds of foods that your body was literally designed to use for fuel and to get off of the kinds of foods that have been making you fat, right? Or have been making you sick. And the cool thing is, when you get into whole foods and fermented foods, you begin to run your brain better, because your gut is your first brain. It's all connected, people. And I can't talk about personal mastery without talking about food and health. I can't talk about self-hypnosis without talking about food and health. I can't talk about success without talking about what's going on. What are you telling yourself? You know, what questions are you asking yourself? What images are you running on your mental movie screen? That is all part of this process. And I don't know how you found me, but I want to welcome you. I want to encourage you. I want to absolutely challenge you with love and kind of the best kind of parenting that I can possibly give, to demand that you start doing the things that I suggest that you do when you're ready to start doing the things that I suggest that you do. And again, it's always your choice. You are the one in charge of your change. However, I'm here and I want to let you know my commitment is to be here for the next 90 days and to give it absolutely everything I have. And then at the end of my 90 days, I'm going to take a break. I'm going to reevaluate where I'm going and what worked and what didn't work. And I want you to do that with me. So that's it for this morning. It is the fourth day of challenge number 444. It is early January, not so early anymore. I think it's the 11th of January or the 12th. It might be the 12th. I lose track of the days. But whenever you watch this, you might be watching this in 2020. This hopefully will be up. I hope you found this. I hope somehow, because there's no time or space, I'm sending energy out into the universe to connect with you. I am looking for people who want to master their minds for a change and who are open to all the different ways, innovative ways that I do it. I'm not your typical hypnotist, and I'm also not your typical singer-songwriter. I'm combining them in a way that is hopefully healing and empowering and energizing and can somehow convey to you that you are not alone, that I love you, I believe in you, and I also demand that you stop abandoning yourself. I demand that you put some effort into expressing the deepest truth to yourself and to the world, because you are becoming someone who you want to be. And all I'm here to do is help you do it a little faster, a little easier, a little better, but you still have to work, right? Most people don't want to hear that. They want the silver bullet. They want to take a pill. They want someone to do it for them. And unfortunately, that leads to their own pain. So I demand that you begin to open your mind to the fact that you're an amazing being of light. You have all the talent you need. You have all the resources you need. And now it's time to get to work and to be willing to try things that don't work out the way you think they should, to let go of your expectations and to go, okay, I'm going to try this for the next 90 days and see what happens. I'm going to keep track. I'm going to measure where I am when I start, and I'm going to set some goals. I'm going to install them in my timeline, and I'm going to keep track of how I do. And at the end of the 90 days, I'm going to look back and go, okay, this I could have done better. That I did great. How can I do more of what worked and less of what didn't work? And how can I challenge myself to take it to the next level? And ultimately, you can do that no matter where you are, no matter how much education you have, no matter if you had a good childhood or a bad childhood, no matter if you're tall or short, male or female, white or black, Asian, South Pacific Islander, Australian, European, whatever your background, if you are human on this planet, ultimately, we all came from the same place. And hopefully we are going to some place that makes your life make sense. So that's it for this morning. I'm passionate today. I'm fired up, and I've got a lot that I've set out to do today. So I'm going to get this going. I'm going to upload this, and then I'm going to get to work with all the other things that I want to do. And I want you to just carry this thought with you today. You are not alone. I am here with you, and I am encouraging you, and I believe in you. And every day I work on my stuff, and I think, how can I support other people? How can I support you? How can I encourage you? How can I challenge you? How can I share these ideas in a way that you can understand them, that you can be inspired by them, by that how can I share what I do in a way that inspires you to become more of who you want to be? And I will chant that over and over again. That is why I'm here. And I encourage you, if you're here for the first time, dig through my website. If you're seeing me on YouTube, check out some of the links below the video. If you are seeing me on Facebook, friend me, right? Go deeper. Check out my websites. Check out my music. Learn who I am and why I'm walking my walk and talking my talk and walking my talk and doing the best I can every day to be a powerful, positive resource for you so that you can do the same thing in your life in whatever way you want, in whatever way works for you. And to know, this is a long journey. I'm here for the long journey. I want you with me. I'd like to look back 5 years from now and know, wow, you were here in 2017 with me and you're still with me, and look at your life now. Look at you blossom and bloom and grow. That's what turns me on. That's what motivates me every day to get up early, to stay up late, to do all the things that need to be done and some of the things I don't want to do so that I can communicate this message to you. You are here for a purpose. I don't know what that purpose is, and maybe your purpose is to discover your purpose, right? And it may take you 40 years. It may take you 1 year. It may take you a day. I don't know. But it's worth doing. It's worth doing. So that's my message today. And again, remember that everything I do, particularly my longer videos, my longer audios, it's all conversational hypnosis. You can play this. You can take the audio track and put it in your phone and play it over and over and over again while you're working out, while you're going for a walk, while you're knitting or taking out the garbage or whatever it is you're doing through your day that might be time when you're not improving. You can put the headphones on and my voice will go with you. Whether it's an actual eyes closed hypnosis session or one of these videos or audios, that is conversational hypnosis. And everything I say for a reason. Sometimes I don't know why I say it. Because it's a trance. It's transformation. So that's it for today. Mark Shepard, the singing hypnotist, your mind mastery mentor, modern Jedi, honest hypnosis practitioner, whatever it is you want to call me. I just want you to know from my heart that I believe in you. And I demand that you believe in yourself a little bit more today than you did yesterday. All right, that's it. Over and out. I will talk to you tomorrow.